course, maybe many of you are thinking in your mind, so she's not coming from university as a professor or something, so who is she? Okay, I'm a bakery developer in a big farm company in Japan. It's called Nisshin Family. I'm usually doing developments of bakery products, technical advice to clients. My clients like convenience stores and big manufacturer bakery and pastry shops, and also small retail specialty shops. And also, I sometimes do lectures about wheat flour and food science to them. My company produces wheat flour not only in Japan, but also in several countries in the world. And so, not here. And so, two companies actually are in here, Thailand. So in Thailand, this one, the Nisshin STC Glovering Company, and also another one, Thai Nisshin Technomic, this is premix for our company we have. So we've been supplying high quality wheat flour and premix stably and always support our customers in Asia with our technical service. So today, I'm very glad to share some of my knowledge and experiences with you all in here, Thailand, which is my favorite and also familiar country. Okay, let's talk about sweet in Japan. Before that, so what is your image about Japan? Today, it's all about sweet in Japan. Japanese people like sweets very much. If you go to Japan, please stop by supermarkets or department stores. There is a wonderful sweet paradise, and you'll find how much the people like sweets. For example, Japan is the best consumer of chocolate in Asia. Also, even in a small town, you can find nice cozy specialty shops, and the lovely sweets in the showcase will make you smile and feel happy. Just before I talk about Japanese sweets in the current market, now I will introduce about Japanese traditional sweets that Japanese people have been loving for a long time over history. The sweet is called Wakashi. Is there anyone who has ever tried it in Japan? Generally, wakashi is often served with tea. Now, you can get wakashi everywhere in Japan, but many of the finest wakashi shops are around Kyoto. Wakashi chefs make the sweet with a fine selection of ingredients and their wonderful technique like this. So this looks like how to make sushi, right? So very handmade. So early 8th century, the history of sweet in Japan began from China. But later, in 13th and 14th century, Japanese monks who have been to China brought the new Chinese culture to Japan, and the original form of current wakashi just has begun. From 15th century, tea ceremony became popular. Generally, wakashi was taken with Japanese tea in the tea ceremonies, so that wakashi became popular with this culture. 16th century, new sweets came from Spain and Portugal. The sugar-rich sweets were so new for Japanese at that time that the sweets attracted people very much. From 17th to 18th century, wakashi was getting more sophisticated and expanding among only upper class people. But finally, the beginning of 19th century, wakashi became more common for ordinary people. So these are features of Wakashi. Healthy, enjoyed with five senses, and closely intertwined with seasons and occasions. At first, healthy. These are main ingredients for Wakashi, like rice and sugar. Basically, they are vegetable ingredients only, so that Wakashi is cholesterol-free and also has relatively less fat content. But especially highly important ingredients for Wakashi are these red beans. They have high protein, high dietary fiber, and also plenty of polyphenol, like this is antioxidants. The main use of these beans for Wakashi is to make sweet paste, this one, red bean paste. This is moist, smooth, and tasty. This red bean paste is used for many varieties of Wakashi like them. Okay, the second feature of Wakashi is to enjoy with five senses. The first sense is sight. Wakashi has so artistic, beautiful appearance. Even before we taste, we can quite enjoy to see the appearance. Second is taste. Wakashi doesn't use so many kinds of ingredients for one product. It's very simple, so that you can feel and enjoy the flavors of individual ingredients and also the harmony of the combination. Third is smell. Aroma from Wakashi should be subtle for bringing out the aroma and flavor of tea. Fourth is sound. In Wakashi, the sound of a name stimulates our imaginative response. Here is an example. This Wakashi is from an old famous Wakashi shop. This is named Asakaoru in Japanese, that means fragrant morning. So the pale pink flower, can you see? This the pale pink flower represents beautiful morning glory, which is well known that opens every morning in summer. Also, can you see some small transparent jellies on this? It represents water drops, probably just after it's water. So that now you can imagine how fresh and beautiful this scenery is in one summer morning. So it's interesting to think about how Wakashi chefs express beautiful nature and sceneries with Wakashi, isn't it? The fifth sense is touch. How do you feel on your tongue when you're eating? How do you feel when you cut the Wakashi with your toothpick? Chewy, moist, crunchy. There are different textures in Wakashi and you can enjoy them. The last feature of Wakashi is to be related to seasons and occasions in your life. Probably you know, Japan has beautiful four seasons. Wakashi gives brilliant expressions to this country's season. In spring, many kinds of flowers, including cherry blossom, bloom. It's the most colorful season in Japan. That's why many of Wakashi in spring are derived from flower. Summer in Japan is very hot and humid. You may have a poor appetite, so that there are many Wakashi that look, sound, and texture are cool. Autumn is the harvest season and beautiful with color leaves. Many fruit and nuts like chestnuts grow ripe, which are used in autumn Wakashi. Also, we celebrate the harvest by offering rice dumpling to the moon, like this. In winter, it's cold and clear outside. Winter Wakashi makes people's body and mind warm. There are special Wakashi to celebrate New Year as well. Also, there is Wakashi for special occasions in our lives. For example, on Girls' Festival and Boys' Festival, we eat specific Wakashi like them to pray for kids growing healthily and also prosperity of you understand, Wakashi has taken root in the life of Japanese people in a long history, and how now Wakashi is a sort of necessity for people. Late 19th century, a new culture came to Japan. That's from America and also European countries like France and England. At that time, Japanese people just met many Western sweets like chocolate and caramels for the first time. It was the start of westernization of sweet market in Japan. Comparison of wagashi and Western sweets. Wagashi is mainly made from rice and also vegetable ingredients only. Western sweets, it's primarily made from wheat flour and also contains animal ingredients like eggs, butter, and milk. Wakashi has so artistic visual, sometimes you have to imagine what they mean because the visual are so abstract. But Western sweets visual is more clear about what they are made from at once. Wakashi is subtle. As I told you, the culture of wakashi was growing with Japanese tea ceremony for a long time. That's why basically wakashi are understated not to disturb aroma and flavor of tea. On the other hand, Western sweets have something bolder, like aromas with liquors or the vivid color. Now you can find many varieties of Western sweets in the market. Our first, European sweets. These are common European sweets in Japan. I know some of them are in here Thailand as well. Macaron and also cream puff are especially popular. Now in Japan, there are many pastry chefs who have been to Europe for a decent time and learned how to make European sweets properly. That's why the European sweet in Japan is still getting more sophisticated and better day by day. This graphic is the example of European sweet localized in Japan. Crepe is a thin pancake from France. In France, crepe is usually eaten like this, on a plate with knife and fork. But in Japan, this photo, Japanese crepe is a handy casual sweet that you can enjoy on the street. There are many varieties of rich filling inside, like whipped cream and fruits. Secondly, American sweets. These are common American sweets in Japan. Compared with European sweets, they look simpler and more homemade. You can enjoy them with a cup of coffee. This is a good example of pancake. So this is an example. For the last 4 years, pancakes, especially these Hawaiian pancakes, have been super popular in Japan. You can find long lines outside famous shops in Tokyo. The feature of Hawaiian type is to be topped with so much whipped cream, fruit, and sometimes coconut. It's not cheap at all. If you order this one in a famous shop, can you guess the price? It must be around 15 to 20 US dollars. So I know, so you are food experts, so you can easily imagine how much is the cost. So it doesn't sound bad, is it? If I'm fired by my company, I'd like to start this business. And these are Japanized Western sweets, means localized versions of popular European and American sweets. Roll cake, this one, is lighter, moister sponge cake with more whipped cream compared with Western one. Donuts can sometimes become chewy, like a rice dumpling. Crepe from France, which I just mentioned. This has changed the shape like a piece of cake. But Probably the best known example of Japanese Western sweets is this strawberry shortcake. Originally, it's from America, which used short biscuits, but Japanese one used egg-rich sponge cake. Japanese people really love this combination of sponge cake, whipped cream, and red strawberries. Wedding, birthday, Christmas Day, we eat it many occasions in our life. Another example of Japanese Western sweet is kawaii sweet. Kawaii is a Japanese word which means cute and sweet. Many Western sweets in added this kawaii essence in Japan, and sometimes a factor of popularity. In recent years, the Japanese confectionery market is steadily expanding by about 1% per year. The share of confectionery market channels, convenience stores, department stores, and also traffic channels, including the airport. These three channels are expanding. Now, I'll talk about convenience stores sweet market like this, which is significantly expanding. For the last 5 years, the convenience sweet market has been steadily increasing by around 20%. Why have the convenience store sweets become that popular? Let's see the feature of them and find the secrets. Features of convenience store sweets. First, great quality similar to specialty shops. Now, convenience store sweets use high-quality ingredients like fresh cream, also nice quality chocolate, same as specialty shops. Second, affordable price. Now, the quality is very similar to specialty shops, but the price in convenience stores is still cheaper than them. Third, ease of eating. You can eat them not only at home with tea, but also at your office, in your car, also on the bench outside, very casually. Fourthly, perfect pairing with a coffee. Now, almost all major convenience stores have their coffee makers in stores, and the fresh brewed coffee is very popular. So, convenience stores also focus on developing sweets which can match with coffee like donuts. Now, every convenience store has a big showcase for donuts just next to the coffee machine. Common convenience store sweets. Representative one is roll cake. I think your country has the same one. Also, some wakashi, including children. This is interesting. Only one convenience store shop has four different types of ping pong in a line in the same showcase. So which has slightly different, but so you can choose your favorite taste, your favorite texture, but four different types are too much, no? So I usually develop this kind of stuff, and convenience stores request is very sometimes demanding. So it's very difficult to make each type of shopping. So there are some sweets, eaten warm, and also this is a soft ice cream. So once you order at the counter, you can get a fresh one. So these are American sweet varieties in convenience stores. Now you can find how much American sweets have been accepted by Japanese people. Okay, what is required for Japanese sweets for future? I think one keyword is healthy. In the background, there is an aging society in Japan. Recently, the population in Japan has been decreasing slightly, and the percentage of over 65 years old is increasing rapidly. We think this tendency will not change in the future, and her consciousness is getting stronger. Thus, some sweets are required to have her oriented feature. Some examples in the market. These are health-oriented chocolate, high cacao stuff, and also this contains lactic acid bacteria to smooth your stomach or something like that. These are health-oriented energy sticks, which contains lots of dietary fiber, protein, vitamin, mineral, and more. Some more. These rare sweets are very common in Japan now. Because dietary fiber is very rich in it. Also, you can find local recipes. This is an example. This is glucomanna chips. It's like potato chips, but the ingredient is not potato. It's glucomanna. It's like sugar, dietary fiber. So, even though this is deep fried, but the color is very less. But the taste and the texture is quite different, actually. Okay, summary. Wakashi is Japanese traditional sweet. Wakashi is relatively healthy and attracts your five senses. Wakashi is beside you in all seasons and special occasions in your life. In current Japan, Western sweets and Japanese sweets are very popular. You can see good quality sweets in not only specialty shops, but also convenience stores and airports. Sweets will be required to be more healthy in the future because of aging society. In this month, I know many of you are very excited with the Olympics Games. I also have sort of lack of sleep because of this. In 2020, the Olympics is held in Tokyo. Many foreigners would come to Japan. So for sure, there will be a good opportunity to showcase to the world to the uniqueness of this Japanese sweet culture. Thank you.